Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Orphea and today's video is gonna be my Q&A. For today's video, I asked you guys to submit questions for a Q&A and that's what I'm gonna be answering today. So I'm gonna use my app, go to that video and just start answering questions. I'm gonna try not to make my answers too super long and otherwise editing me is gonna have a lot of fun with this. So right now on my phone, I am on my video, I have your questions open, so I'm gonna start out and read all of them. So let's go through the questions, and the first one we're gonna start with are the questions from Jossie Ayame, who is actually a friend of mine. First one, she asks, which band or artist are you hoping to see this year? This year I hope to see a band that I haven't seen before, which is The Birthday Massacre. They're one of my all-time favorite bands and I haven't seen them live yet, so I'm really looking forward to that. Next one is, do you have any plans for new piercings or just tattoos? This is something that I don't really talk about too much if I have plans for things. Of course, I have lots of tattoo plans. I just recently got two new piercings done and I'm gonna talk about them on my channel if you guys are still interested in piercing videos. I still hope to get something else done in this ear that hopefully isn't a cartilage piercing because my helix rejected, but I still want something extra done in this ear, and then I don't know. I just go as I feel with piercings. Also with piercings, it's not as definitive as tattoos. You can take them out, you can remove them, but I do find the pain and the healing process of piercings more annoying than the ones of tattoos. Anyhow, so yes, I always have tattoo plans. I always have way too many tattoo plans, but piercings not specifically. And piercings are something that I get done more easily. If it just pops in my head that I want a certain piercing, I will contact my piercer, ask her the pros and cons of that piercing, send her pictures of my body if I can, and ask her for advice on it. So that's what I mostly do with piercings. And if I want to get them, I just go to my piercer, who is Verlo from Skin Culture. She's an amazing piercer. And then Jossie's final question, what's your favorite accessory to complete any outfit? And the fun thing is, I'm not wearing it today, but usually one of my personal favorite accessories are nose chains. I absolutely love the way they look, but I think that nose chains are actually one of my favorite accessories. And if you're looking for nose chains, Jossie makes them. So she has her own shop, which is called Ayame Designs. She did not ask me to put this in the video, by the way. She makes earrings, she makes necklaces, but she also makes lots of nose chains. So if you're looking into getting a nose chain, go and have a look. I will link her in the description box of this video. Next, I have a kind of weird question from Mr. Shoes Matt, asking, if you found out your male friend had a boot fetish and wanted to clean and polish all your boots, what would you do? He's a nice fella. If you're a friend of mine and you don't talk to me about this, you're not a friend of mine, because all of my friends know that I'm a super easygoing person and I don't judge anyone for anything. So if this person is really a friend of mine, they would have talked to me about it. So guessing from this comment, you're not someone who knows me personally. Then we have some questions from Ona Lunches. First one, sweetie, when are you coming to Canada? Canada is on my list, but it's really far away and the flights are pretty expensive. So I prefer going to other colder countries first. And then our second question is a really hard one. If you could pick one Killstar item that's on your wish list, which one is it? It's really difficult for me because Killstar constantly comes out with more stuff. Do I think all Killstar stuff is worth their price? No. Do I think a few of them are? Absolutely yes. And I only recently got one of my like holy grail items. There's this really pretty lace dress that I have in black and I also wanted it in the red version. And I'm not sure how, but someone sold it on a secondhand website and I was first one to comment on the dress and I got it. And it's beautiful and I love it so much. I haven't worn it out yet, but I have it. And that was for a long time my holy grail item from Killstar. Right now there's a few things that I'm eyeing, but there's nothing that I really need in my life to be happy. The one thing that I do still want to get from Killstar that I don't have yet is the Assassin hoodie, the really big one with the shawl kind of thing. Main issue with it is, usually you have to size up in Killstar items, but for that one you have to size down. A friend of mine has the medium, which is super big on me, and another friend has the small, which is also kind of big on me, so I would need the extra small, and it's just forever sold out. And I got a few questions and I'm not sure if I'm supposed to reply to them. They're from Christy Exists. And she asks, is there any type of questions that you don't like to answer? I'm usually not very good at answering very personal questions, talking about me, how I'm doing, etc. That's something that I usually am not very good at. Do you have any topics that you prefer answering to more than others? The main things that I like answering questions about are things related to the god subculture. So they could be makeup tips and tricks, they could be music advice, they could be anything that is related to being alternative to being god. That's the things that I like to talk about, that I'm actually passionate about, and that I hope to bring back to my channel more this year. And then we have a bunch of questions from Quantum Physica. Favorite shoes? Definitely my New Rocks with the wedge heel. They are my go-to shoes anywhere I go. Favorite visual inspirations? I love going off of movies and mainly also movie posters, because they create such a striking image. They can be very intricate, they can be very simple and plain. And I do love using Pinterest to gather boards of things that inspire me. But mainly if I go off of visual elements, I will be inspired by movies and series that I watch, because it's just something that I really personally enjoy. And then the final question is, any important realization or realizations you've had that sent you into a specific direction in life or altered your outlook on it? I'm not really sure how to answer this question. I've had a few realizations in the course of my life. First of all, I don't need anyone to be happy. I need myself to be happy. And I don't want or need to rely on others to feel good. And that's something very important that I realized, because I had always kind of depended on other people's happiness to feel happy. I would always put more effort into those people, into making the people around me happy, than into actually looking after myself. And that is something that has changed dramatically the past year. If you've been on my channel, you know that I stopped doing certain things and that I totally switched around other things in my life, and I feel so much better about it. Right now I think about myself first, then my cat, and then other people. which is something that you really have to teach yourself to do. Look after yourself first. If you're not okay, you can't help other people be okay. And that's something that I had to learn the hard way. Second thing is that it's not because someone else is happy about a situation that you should be. If someone else wants to have a perfect marriage with kids, with a house, with a garden, whatever, that's their thing. That doesn't define your happiness, or in this case, my happiness. I can be perfectly happy in my apartment with my cat Lucky, going to festivals, going to parties, DJing as much as I can, dancing my ass off, doing pretty makeup, filming at random evenings during the week, because that's what I want to do, and that is exactly how I want to live my life at this moment, and that's exactly what makes me happy at this moment, and that is what I will be doing. Then a very deep question by Hayshaker: why is there so much suffering in the world? I have no idea. People should be happier, people should be more considering towards each other, more tolerant, and then I think the world will be fine, actually. And then we have a few questions from Emily Boo, and if you don't know Emily Boo, she's one of my personal favorite YouTubers here, so go to her channel if you don't know her yet. She's super bright and bubbly. What would be the very first thing you bought if you won billions on the lottery? I would buy myself my dream house, or even better, I would build my own dream house. That is something that I think is my main goal if I win a lot of money. Also travel the world, go to all of the festivals that I want, go to all of the cities that I want to visit, to all of the countries, to just be free and do whatever I want. I would not maybe quit my job, I would still continue doing it, but not on a full-time basis as I'm doing right now. Next she asks, who's your celebrity crush? Chris Motionless is definitely a crush of mine. Who do you like to watch on YouTube? I need new faces to follow. So who do I watch actively on YouTube? It's Emily Boo. Toxic Tears, I'm pretty sure you are both familiar with each other. I also like watching Michelle B. I like Tasmania TV a lot, Amina Critique, of course. But honestly, I stopped spending so much time on YouTube because it kind of consumed my life a little bit too much. So those are the main channels that I currently still watch. And then finally she asks, most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to you? I'm not gonna go into ever happened to me, but I will go into recently happened to me. When I was in Stockholm, Sweden, I went to the Motionless in White concert and I was wearing a gorgeous skirt by Gilstar. It's their, I'm not sure what it's called exactly, it's a really nice skirt that falls into flowy fabric and it is really nice and it is high-waisted and it has this gorgeous, it's not a pentacle, it's a witch's symbol on it. There was a mosh pit, and if you kind of know me at concerts, I jump around and go crazy in mosh pits. I am one of those crazy girls who will be jumping their ass off in a mosh pit. And the skirt thing that was attached to it was actually so heavy that it started pulling the zipper down, and I almost lost my skirt in the mosh pit of Motionless in White in Stockholm, Sweden, surrounded by strangers. Awesome, right? Next is a question by Ronnie. What was your best memorable concert, festival, or event? Doesn't matter what country or year, your all-time favorite. This is a very, very difficult one because there are a few concerts that have defined me as a person and my style of music and the way that I continued to listen to music and go to concerts. So I'm just gonna go with the most memorable one that comes to my mind is the very first concert, like actual concert that I went to, which was from Dimmu Borgir. I think I was 15 or 16 at the time, really big into metal. And that's the night that I met a lot of people that I'm still into contact with to this day. It's what introduced me to the metal community, to the metal scene, to the actual people in it. And it's changed my life forever. So I think that's my most memorable concert. And then if we go to recent ones, definitely Motionless in White. I've seen them twice recently, once in Stockholm, Sweden, and then the second time in Belgium, and they were so good. So for me, it's something very personal, actually, music. Music is what makes me happy, what makes me feel me. If I wouldn't have my music, then I wouldn't be me. If I don't have my makeup, my hair, my clothes, I don't care as long as I have my music. So yeah, this was actually way too deep of an answer for this question, so let's continue. Then we have a question by Cindy Cahill. Do you get aware of certain tics that you might have, and what are they? Because I certainly notice mine if I'm sat in front of a screen the whole time and repeat the same part over and over. So it becomes quite clear that I have certain things or words I say a lot. Yes, of course I do. I think for me, it's especially stumbling over my words and then having to edit that out. I tried not to have too many ums, and then now, of course, I do it for sure a lot. It's also difficult sometimes because I can't always find the correct words to use, so I kind of just make up whatever. But editing is a super fun thing to help out with that and fix all of the stupid things that I do. Then we have questions by Uggy. What was the first God song or album that got you into God? Now, this is a difficult one because I got into metal and then metal-ish God music before I actually knew what God was and actually started appreciating God even more. This is actually really difficult because I've always been in this weird mix of electronic goth music and electronic metal industrial music. I think the first actual songs or albums that got me into what is considered goth nowadays might have been Aesthetic Perfection. One of the first times that I went to a party which was called Nocturna, there was Aesthetic Perfection. I believe that's one of the first bands that I actually started actively listening to into what is considered goth electronic music. If it is considered gothic wave music, the goth rock music, I think it must be She Passed Away, that really got me intrigued with that music more. What is your advice to when dressing out in public and family as God? Wear what you want, as long as you feel comfortable in it. Now, honestly, when I go out with family, I try to turn it down just a little bit. If you look at my God at the Office lookbook, that's sort of what I will wear if I'm out with family. If I'm out with friends, anything goes, any makeup goes, etc. But with family, I try to turn it down just a little bit. Also because no one in my family is actually alternative. They don't mind me at all. Like, if I would be like this at any family gathering, they would be completely absolutely fine with it. The only thing that I personally pay attention to, especially with family, is that I don't have too many of my tattoos showing, because my grandparents, more specifically, are very sensitive to them. Otherwise, my family is completely chill and completely cool with the way I look. Even if I were to go out wearing one of my more extreme outfits, they would not care, they do not mind, because they know I'm just me. The other thing with dressing up in public is that you have to feel confident. If you don't feel confident, you're gonna think that people are staring at you, which they probably are, but if you're confident enough, you're just simply not gonna care. However, there is one thing that has helped me tremendously feeling more confident in public, is to having in-ears with music and listening to music while walking around town. Because most of the time, if I'm out in public without anyone to talk to, without any friends, then the music is actually really helping me and distracting me from everything that's happening around me. And over time, if you do it more and more, you will just feel more confident. You will know that people don't care, that they don't mind. So it's a win-win situation, in my opinion at least. If you don't feel confident, then try and take it in little steps. Start dressing a little bit more toned down, then put in some elements. For me, the main difference, if people stare at me or not, is actually my makeup and not specifically what I'm wearing. I could be wearing the exact same thing with and without makeup. Without makeup, people will not even look twice at me. With makeup, they will be staring. So that's something here where I live locally that people pay attention to more, is the way my face looks than the way I'm dressed, actually. So, but that's just here, of course, in Belgium, in tiny village next to Ghent where I live. And then the final one is, do you think the discussion about what God is and what isn't is as important in real life as it seems to be online? It seems to be a subject that makes people easily triggered, but in real life I've barely met gods who discuss this. Well, the main reason why you see it online so much is because people like to be behind their keyboards and type. If you talk to people in real life, people are a lot more chill about this, because most people who are God, they honestly don't care that much. We do, but we are accepting of all different layers and styles of God and all different types of people who are into God, who are new to it, who have been around for ages, who like different types of music, because that's what God is. And people at God festivals are so respectful, are so kind, are so sweet, and I don't get why online there's so many keyboard ragers. I think it's mainly those people that never go out, that never see the sunlight, that never see the moonlight, or that never see God events, God clubs, because honestly, in my opinion at least, gods are some of the most accepting, sweet people that are out there, and if you will talk to them about what God is and isn't, they will have a short discussion about it, find something in common that they like, and then start talking about that. Or they will start recommending each other music, which is amazing, honestly. That's what happens most of the time in real life. And online, honestly, I tend to shut down those discussions, because it's very subjective. It depends a lot on how the person is, how they got involved in the God movement, and what they consider to be God. And it can be very, very different. For me, God is all things spooky and dark and creepy and out of the box. For some other people, God is only trad God, specific type of music, very boxy thinking. Not my way of thinking about God, by the way. But that's just up to those people to decide what they do with it. And I don't like to go into those discussions, because they're endless and they're pointless, and I have so many better things to do with my life. Anyhow, I hope this answers all of the questions you had. These are all the questions that were asked on my Q&A. Should you still have any questions at all, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I make 2 videos a month at least, or I'm trying to make them, because nothing goes as I want it right now. But that's life, and we'll get through it, and everything will get better. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon to get notifications of when I upload my videos. I want to thank you so, so much for watching, and I will see you very soon. Bye!